Hello students, welcome to Don Bosco PU College online classes. We are trying our best to make teaching learning experience easy to our students. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update.
Hi my dear students, this is Harish from Don Bosco PU College, Chitradurga. So in this video I would like to discuss the model question paper 2 who provided the PU board 2020 and 21. So I would like to only give the solutions to the model paper 2. Clear? I think all of you have a model question paper 2 question paper. To that question paper, I want to discuss the solutions. Clear? See, all of you have a question paper. Please and open the question paper and write the solutions to that those questions. Clear? So let us be discussing about first one, part one. Like for 1 mark questions, please open the textbook, all of you. Model question paper 2. The first question is like this. An operation star on Z plus is defined as A star B is equal to modulus of A minus B for all A comma B belongs to Z plus is defined as star is a binary operation. This is the first question. To that question the solution is, so here given for all a comma b belongs to z plus, which is implies modulus of a minus b belongs to z plus. This is the given question, whether this question is a binary or not. So we have to check, take two examples from the z plus. 2 comma 3 belongs to Z plus, which is implies modulus of 2 minus 3, which is equals to the modulus of 2 minus 3 is 1. 1 belongs to Z plus. So 1 belongs to Z plus means therefore star is a binary operation. Clear? Second question. Next we go for second question. The second question is like this. Write the domain and domain of the inverse of the function sine inverse of x. So what is the domain of the function sine inverse of x means? Second one, the domain of sine inverse of x is closed interval minus pi by 2 comma plus pi by 2. So this is the domain of the function sine inverse of x. Next, third question, construct a 2 cross 2 matrix A is equal to Aij whose elements are given by Aij is equal to I plus j whole square divided by 2. So first here we have to consider the 2 cross 2 matrix whose elements are given by like this. So consider matrix A is equal to A11, A12 first row elements and the second row elements A21, A22. Clear? The given problem is Aij is equal to I plus j whole square by 2. This is the given problem. From this problem we have to construct a matrix A 2 cross 2 matrix. Clear? First we have to find out A11 element is equal to 1 + 1 whole square divided by 2. 1 + 1 means 2, 2 square means 4 by 2, answer is 2. Next to A12 is equal to 1 + 2 whole square by 2 is equal to 1 + 2 means 3, 3 square means 9, 9 by 2. Next to second row A21 is equal to your I and J means 2 + 1 whole square by 2, answer is 9 by 2. Next A22 is equal to 2 + 2 whole square divided by 2. 2 + 2, 4, 4 square means 16 by 2, answer is 8. So from this equation we will get 4 elements. So if these 4 elements substitute the matrix A is equal to, then the matrix is A is equal to, the first element is 2, 9 by 2 and 8. This is the solutions of third problem. Next we go for question number 4. The question number 4 is, if A is a square matrix and the adjoint of A is equal to 5 0 0 5, so find the determinant of A. The given matrix is A is equal to 5 0 0 5. So we have to find out the determinant of A. Clear? So determinant of A is equal to 5 5 is 25 minus 0. Therefore the value of determinant of A is equal to 25. So next question number 5. Question number 5 is, if y is equal to cos of root x, find dy by dx. So from this equations we have to find out dy by dx. So how to find out the dy by dx means by differentiating the given function, differentiating with respect to x. Differentiation of y is dy by dx is equal to differentiation of cos of root x. First we have to differentiating the outside the function. Here cos is there. Differentiation of cos means minus sine of root x into again differentiation of root x divided by dx. Clear? So therefore dy by dx is equal to minus sine root x whole divided by, again derivatives of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Is it right? That 1 by 2 root x right in the denominator, 2 into root x. So this is the required solution. Understood? Next we go for question number 6. Okay? Number 6. Integrating root of ax plus b into dx. So what is the integration of root of ax plus b means? Before we integrating the root of ax plus b, first we should write integration of ax plus b whole to the power of 1 by 2 into dx. So here x to the power of 1 can be written as x to the power of 2 by 2. By applying the formula x to the power of n is equal to x to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. By using this formula we have to differentiating the given function, which is equals to ax plus b whole to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by 1 by 2 plus 1. Clear? which is also equals to 1 by 2 plus 1 means 3 by 2 agate, that 3 by 2 can be written as 2 by 3 ax plus b whole to the power of this 1 by 2 plus 1 means 3 by 2. The constants comes to denominator divided by a plus c. So this is the integration of root of ax plus b. Clear? Here the coefficient of x is a. This a comes to denominator. Clear? In our integrations, all constants comes on the denominator. In the differentiation, all the constants are comes in coefficient of x comes in left side. Clear? Next, question number 7. The question number 7 is like this. Find the scalar and vector component of the vector with the initial point p of 2, 1 and terminal point q of minus 5, 7. So here the initial point is capital A of 2, 1, which is implies OA is equal to 2i plus j, and b of minus 5, 7, which is implies OB vector is equal to minus 5i plus 7j. Clear? So here we have to find out AB vector is equal to, what is the formula for AB vector? Means OB vector minus OA vector. Here OB vector means minus 5i plus 7j, close the bracket, minus of OA vector means 2i plus j. Clear? Then AB vector is equal to minus 5i plus 7j minus 2i minus j. So if you have to simplify, this one means minus 5i minus 2i is equal to minus 7i plus 7j minus j is equal to 6j. Therefore, AB vector is equal to minus 7i plus 6j. In this given vector, AB vector is, the vector components are minus 7i and 6j. These are the vector components. Understood? Next question. Question number 8. In your model paper, the question number 8 is, find the distance of the plane 3x minus 4y plus 12z minus 3 is equal to 0 from the origin. So here we have to consider a is equal to 0. Consider a is equal to 0. Then n is equal to, n vector is equal to 3i minus 4j plus 12k. Clear? And distance d is equal to 3. Minus 3 kodidaralla adana distance d na plus 3 agi convert maadkobeku. Then what is the formula for finding the distance of the plane from the origin? Means distance d, capital D, is equal to modulus of a vector n vector minus d vector by modulus of n vector. Magnitude, which is implies d is equal to modulus of 0 into, because of the way vector is 0, into n vector means 3i minus 4j plus 12k minus d means 3 whole divided by square root of, what is the formula for magnitude of n vector? Means square root of 3 square means 9 plus square root of 4 square means 16 plus square root of 12 square means 144. Clear? Close the modulus. So then d is equal to distance modulus of 0 into a vector is 0 minus 3 divided by square root of 169, which is also implies d is equal to 3 by square root of 169 means 13. So therefore the distance d is equal to 3 by 13 units. This is the required distance. Clear? Next to problem number 9. The problem number 9 asking from the linear programming problem chapter. What is the question 9 means in your model paper? Define objective function. What is the definition of objective function? I think all of you well known. Objective function. So here, this is very important to definition. This one is optimal solution, optimal objective function, constraints. These definitions are very, very important in your annual examination. Clear? So here, objective function. Define objective function means a linear function. Function z is equal to ax plus by, comma, where a comma b are constants in the equation z is equal to ax plus b. Here a and b are what? Constant, which has to be maximized or minimized, called objective function. Called what? Objective function. Next to question number 10 on your model paper. The question number 10 is like this. So here, if f is an event of the sample space S of a random experiment, then find p of S bar f. P of S bar f. Clear? So here, p of S bar f is equal to Bayes theorem definition, p of S, and a conditional probability definition. P of S bar is equal to, idana now find out madakkelidane, we should find out this one. By applying the condition probability definition, p of S intersection F by p of F is equal to S intersection F means p of F divided by F and divided by p of F. So here p of f get cancelled. Answer is 1. This is the 10th question solution. Clear? Next we go for question number 11. Part 2. Clear? Question number 11. These are the 2 mark questions. Dear students, the 2 mark question, first question is like this. On R, defined by A star B is equal to A plus B by 2, verify whether the operation star is a associative or not. Clear? Question number 11, A star B is equal to given. On R, A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. Verify star is a associative or not. Clear? We know that A star B star C is equal to A star B star C. Is it right? Actually, this is the definition of what? Associative law. Here we should write within the bracket A star B and B star C. So what is the formula for here? A star B is equal to A plus B by 2. A plus B by 2. Close the bracket. Star C is also equals to A star B plus C by 2. Clear? Close the bracket. So next, continue. Again, by applying the same definition, A plus B by 2 plus C by 2 is also equals to A plus B plus C by 2 whole divided by 2. Again, we are applying this definition. Here, in the place of D means we just consider D. D star C is equal to D plus C by 2. This is E, just consider E. A star E is equal to A plus E by 2. E means B plus E by 2. And here A means A plus B by 2. Finally, we concluded that A plus B plus 2C, take LCM here, whole divided by 4 is also equals to 2A plus B plus C whole divided by 4. But here observe this equation. Observe this equation. A plus A is equal to 2A. It is not possible. So that's why which is not equal to 2A. Same 2C is not equal to C. So that's why therefore star is not associative. Star is not associative. Clear? This is not an associative operation. Clear? Next, we go for question number 12. Question number 12. Find the value of cos inverse of 1 by 2 plus 2 into sin inverse of 1 by 2. So, which is implies? Cos inverse of 1 by 2 means, in which angle cos is 1 by 2 means cos 60 degree plus 2 into sin inverse of 1 by 2. In which angle sin is 1 by 2 means sin 30 degree. So here cos inverse and cos both are reciprocals. That's why it will be cancelled. 60 degree plus 2 into sin inverse and sin both are inverse. So 30, which is also implies 60 degree plus 2 3 is a 6, 60 degree. So totally which is implies 60 plus 60, 120 degree. This is the value of cos inverse of 1 by 2 plus 2 sin inverse of 1 by 2. Got it? Next, we go for question number 13. Question number 13. Find the equation of line joining points 1 comma 2 and 3 comma 6 using the determination. So how to find out the equation of line from these points means, we know that solution. We know that area of a triangle, triangle is given by area A is equal to half into determinant of x1, y1, 1, x2, y2, 1, x3, y3, 1. So this is the formula for area of a triangle in the determinants. Clear? Next, here the given points are like x comma y. Third point we should consider x comma y. And first point is 1 comma 2. and 3, 6. All these 3 points we should consider like x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. So substitute all these values to the given above formula. So area A is equals to half into determinant of x, y, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 6, 1. Clear? Just a substitution. Next to here, equation of find line means all the points are in the same line. So that's why we should consider area is 0 is equals to 1 by 2 into, I think all of you well known how to find out the determinant of order 2. We just take first element means corresponding rows and columns get cancelled. We will get 2 1s are 2 minus 6 1s are 6. Next to minus y into, because of first we should take a plus minus plus. Clear? Corresponding rows and columns means cancel means 1 minus 3. Next plus 1 into corresponding rows and columns cancelled means we will get 6 1s are 6. Minus 6. Clear? So here 6 minus 6, the last term becomes 0. Don't take this element. Of just cross multiply 2 into 0, 0. Only 0 is equal to x into 2 minus 6 minus 4. Minus y into 1 minus 2 means 3 means minus 2. Clear? Which is also implies 0 is equal to x into minus 4 minus 4x minus into minus plus 2 into y 2y. Or this equation can be written as minus 4x shifted to left hand side, it will be changes into plus 4x dividing 2. So 2x is equal to y. This is the required equation of line. Understood all of you? Yes. Next, we go for question number 14. Question number 14. If ax plus by square is equal to by square is equal to cos y, comma, find dy by dx. So in this equation, first we have to find out the first order derivatives, nothing but dy by dx. How to differentiate this one means differentiating with respect to x. Differentiation of ax means x differentiation means 1 into a plus differentiation of b constant, right, as it is. Differentiation of y square is 2y, 2 into y into, again differentiation of y is dy by dx. Clear? Which is also equals to differentiation of cos y is minus y minus sin y into, again y comes means right, dy by dx. Now separating the terms, dy by dx terms. So here 2by into dy by dx plus sin y into dy by dx, the right hand side term minus comes to left hand side, that will be a plus. This plus a shifted to right hand side, that we change into minus a. So the common factor is dy by dx, take it outside. Dy by dx is into 2by plus sin y is equal to minus a. So totally we will get dy by dx means dy by dx is equal to this 2by plus sin y comes to denominator on the right hand side. So totally we will get minus a by 2by plus sin y. Clear? This is the required dy by dx. Clear? Next we go for another problem. Problem number 15. Clear? What is the problem number 15 mean? Show that dy by dx is equal to minus 1 if y is equal to cos inverse of sin x. The given problem is y is equal to cos inverse of sin x. Clear? So here, y is equal to cos inverse of this sin x can be written as cos of pi by 2 minus x. Because of in the first quadrant all trigonometric functions are positive, cos of pi by 2 minus x can be written as sin x, or sin x is equal to cos of pi by 2 minus x. Here cos inverse and trigonometric functions both are cancelled. We will get y is equal to pi by 2 minus x. So now differentiating this function. So differentiating with respect to x. Differentiation of y means we will get dy by dx. Differentiation of constant pi by 2 means 0 minus x means 1, which is implies dy by dx is equal to minus 1. Clear? So this is the required solution for this question. Okay, dear students. So today I would like to stop the class. Next I will discuss the same questions on in the next video. Clear? Thank you. Thank you so much.